Okay, Scott, we're going to review a report here. This is the Alpena one. So always spell out Michigan. All right. Then we can get rid of the listing agent, remove. We'll keep Cindy, the buyer's agent. Okay, and work our way down. Nice looking home. What happened to the picture? Looked like you cut off the bottom. Let me see what you got going here. You must have got that off the internet, eh? Okay. You forgot to get a cover photo, or just didn't? First thing you do when you pull up, before you gotta get a cover photo, Scott. Okay. Well, let me run through the photos here real quick so we see what's going on. Okay. Hey, don't look like too bad of a house from here, but looks like there's quite a bit going on, eh? Okay. And this type of construction, there's no sill plate, and that's okay. You'll see a lot of older homes that don't have a sill plate. Nothing wrong with it. That's just the way it's built. Missing insulation, though. Ground looks like it's kind of damp, maybe. Should have a vapor barrier. Insulation's hanging and some mold and stuff on the, here on this. Looks like some mold on the floor joists. Were those four joists solid, or you gotta make sure you check those, make sure they're not spongy. Sometimes you can tell by looking at them. Sometimes you need to feel them, probe them with a probe or a screwdriver. I don't know if that's a hose on the ground or electrical wire, but either or. Looks like they're supporting this ductwork here with a block and shims, which is fine. You know, they should have, usually there's straps from the ceiling that hold that up, but not a big deal there. Yeah, so it looks like there's a strap here, maybe. Maybe not, can't really tell. There's a strap here, but I don't know if that's just a wire or something holding that pipe there. A lot of moisture in that crawl space. You can see the rusted pipe, the rust on the ductwork there. Yep, it looks like this ductwork fell down. It looked like all this insulation caused it to fall down, eh? This is probably the old septic pipe here. Now they got city sewer. That's the septic pipe, it used to be. Now they're running city sewer. What the heck is this? Huh? Did you see what was going on there? Did you clear it off? You should always have gloves to be able to wipe that off, see what's going on there. I don't know if that's, looks like maybe ABS, black pipe going to the white pipe, maybe. Not good. Yep, that's not good either. A lot of stuff going on there, man. Is that that patio door? Some wasn't properly flashed, and now it's got moisture damage to the wood sill plate. And some dips in the house. Older house, a lot of settling. See the ceiling is lower at one end than the other over here. Then it dips up here. Yes. Yeah, you know, some vinyl tiling here. Not too bad. Open knockout. Pipes a little loose from the wall. A little drip from the shower head. Do not use. Okay. Yep. What you got going there? Got a two pole breaker with one little wire on it. It looks like a 60 amp breaker with a little bitty wire on it. And it's a single wire on a two pole breaker. You're supposed to have a 240, so that's not good. This wire should come down here probably. Yep. Yep. Yeah, I'm not sure why they ran that wire to this breaker. They could have ran it over here to this breaker. But this breaker here, they could have dropped it here. Looks like a 20 amp breaker, hard to tell. Looks like a 15 amp. So depending on if the 12 gauge or you probably move that over here or there, but either way. Yep. Missing knockouts, missing screw. Not sure what you're shooting there. Loose trim board. Yep. Yep, missing Romex connector. The grounds are wrapped around each other instead of wire nutted. Yeah, it's a loose edge. It needs to be tightened up. They're using I can't really see behind there, but it's probably going over here. This is a hot, and this is a hot here. Probably connects on this bottom plate. See this bottom plate? There's a top plate and a bottom plate. So this red wire hooks to this bottom plate, and this top one hooks up to this to the black hooks up, the black wire hooks up to this top plate. So you got 120, and then down here is another 120 equals 240. You got 240 volt. Okay, so, and they got this white wire. They got a black electrical tape. That's just basically a neutral wire. They didn't really need to do that. Not sure why they did that, but strange. Yeah. Anyways, that needs to be cleaned up a little bit. Yep. But this house is not too nice. Excuse me. It needs to be cleaned. It's an older furnace. Failed thermoseal. Yep. A loose seal inside the thermal pane. Yep. Yeah, that was a bad idea. You'll see windows like that now and then. Just a bad design, that seal. Just a defect. I mean, the window's still okay. It hasn't lost the seal. So, I mean, it could have lost it, so I see that one did. Is that an open box there? Yep, it looks like an open electrical box there. What's going on here? Does it look like vermiculite insulation was mixed in with the cellulose? I don't know. It looks kind of like it could be a mixture of cellulose and vermiculite. See, that looks more like vermiculite. That looks like a mixture. All these chunks here. See that chunk. All these chunks here. Thinking it's possibly mixed in. Who knows? Bathroom exhaust vent. Dishwasher don't look too kosher. Nothing there, eh? Supply valves under the sink. That looks like it's going to the dishwasher there. No. Water meter. Wow, this house was a bear. You get through this house, man, you can do any house. What going on there, man? Must be going to the garage, maybe? Or attic? I don't know. I don't look good. I don't look good at all. Yep. Looks like the sill plate got rotted out. Not sure what's going on there. Hard to tell what that is. Looks like the sill plate rotted or missing. But it's a nightmare street. It's a nightmare house. Appreciate you being thorough. Took a lot of photos of all that stuff that's run. It's very good, man. Missing screens, broken siding. What's going on here? Looks like it's could be a area that needs to be resealed here. There's a valley here. There's a valley this way and a valley that way, but this a spot that could be real troublesome. This is a valley. That's not a valley. Okay, this is a valley here. This is straight. This is on an angle. But still, needs to be sealed there. It looks like a flat roof. Some openings there. Poorly finished. What in the world? They burn a lot of wood. Would you believe it? Man, no wonder it took you 2 days to do this. They're not all this bad. Whoa. Man, oh man, this is... Oh, you gotta love Alpina, man. Couple layers of shingles there, yep. Ridge vents. Chimney. No, there's no flashing. Some scaling bricks. Open flue. More scaling bricks. Rubber roof, shingles, ridge vent, soffit vent, looks like some kind of a soffit vent, masthead, roof vents, plumbing vent, don't look too bad, there's no flashing around that one looks pretty bad there. Need to probably, get closer, and yep, nice job. Cleared it out. Nice job, Scott. Missing siding, failed thermal seal, openings on the trim. This is the whole rubber roof mount. ice damming. Well, man, oh man. These people should run. Okay, that's it. Oh, wow. Okay, man, oh man. It's going to be. Okay. Yep, great comment. Let's put in investigate. Yep. Right. You're going to need a vapor barrier. Oh, I didn't see any wall vents, neither. Probably need some ventilation, maybe. Who knows? Where was there was that damage? Well, hopefully you'll mention it. So these are basically Niwa addicts. I wouldn't say overall satisfactory. I know that's a, you know, with quite going, there's quite a few things going on there, but I would say the vinyl siding had, I wouldn't say nothing about it being satisfactory. A few holes in the siding and trim. The vinyl siding had several holes and damaged areas. Right, but just leave it at that. You don't need to say why, I just recommend replacing. Yeah, good. Sometimes it's also reflection off of windows, different like glass, like a sunshine reflecting off a glass, a window, and could cause that too. Let me see what you're looking at here. Yeah, so it's hard to say. We'll just leave it at that. Yep, good. Good. Yep, good. Yep, good. One too many periods here. Okay. Yep, good. Yep, that needs an R. This is bad. Right. Dust seals. Dust seals at the bottom of the entry door are torn and loose. Yep. And can be snipped off. Trying to see that front entry door. I want to see what you're looking at. I don't know if it, I would call that moisture damage, Scott. Maybe weathered. That sounds a little better. Was weathered. Further deterioration may occur if not corrected. Yep, very good. Yeah, you'll see this on those windows. And I'm not sure what kind of wood they use, but I tell you what, I see that a lot on some of these older homes in the area, and that wood is solid, man. Where is it at here? If I can find it here. I guess it don't matter. A lot of photos to get through. Anyways, those are solid. It's amazing how hard they are. I've never seen one rotted yet. These ends here. So, again, not a big deal, but good comment though. Yep, routine painting, caulking maintenance. Yep, very good. Okay. All failed thermal seals should get an R. Good. Good. Okay. Stainless steel. Yeah, I want stainless steel screws. Right. Stainless steel screws won't rust. So. This is that flat roof. Let me move that one front. Yep. I wonder why that is. Nothing was through, so we'll just leave it at that. Good. Well, I mean, who's to say how long it's going to be before they put a roof on? So let's just say this. Okay, how's that sound? The chimney is not flashed with metal flashing, but it is sealed with flashing card. Flashing card maintenance will be required periodically. Metal flashing could be installed, if not now, then at next roof cover replacement. Good. Man, I like that comment. I should be a report writer. Okay, let's see. Let's see how close that is. Did you measure it? Or you just estimated? Not within 10 foot, you're right. Very good. So, yep, if they left the windows open, gas could go psh, right in through there. Yeah, we'll put an I and V there. Good comment. Good catch. Yep, good. That's a flue pipe for the water heater. What? This is the water heater? That needs to be replaced. The contractor to further evaluate and correct or replace as needed. Yeah, good. Yep, got an R on it. I wonder what's venting into here. Let's see what we got going here. The water heater is venting. That was that other thing you said. What's the furnace? What kind of furnace is there? That's the wood one. We got old. This must be going into the where's the flue pipes for the maybe I thought I seen something on the roof. This must be the furnace here, but I don't know. I'm not sure. I mean, I don't know if that's a high efficiency furnace or not. You didn't get it. You only got a. I don't think it is. No, that's not a high efficiency furnace. I want you to, when you do your furnace pictures, I want you to back off. You need to back off and get an overall picture of that furnace and water heater. Even if you need to stand back and turn your camera sideways, I want to see that furnace, Scott. So next time, make sure you get me an overall picture so I can see what's going on with it. Same with that water heater. Okay, so let me go back over here. Okay, so you're calling this. We're going to just go with what you said. I'm going to put an R on that. Yep. Okay. So I have no idea what's venting into this fireplace, I mean into this chimney. There was no fireplace, so it's got to be the furnace. I'm thinking the furnace has got to be venting into this. Okay, so she was recommended for repairs and maintenance to okay. Yep. Yep. Okay, good comment. Good comment. Okay, then I got a comment here that I want to use. Right here. Here's my cheat sheet here. This is an important one. You want to use it every time. Okay? Okay. Capiche? And then same one here is for septic. This would be for a septic. So anyways, always use that one. Repair as needed. I don't like using the word recommend. I mean, we do use it, but not a whole lot. I mean, this here just repair as needed. You don't have to say recommend repair as needed. Just say repair as needed. Sometimes we do recommend. Good. We'll put an INV there. Okay, so we got too many times at inspection here. At the time of the inspection, event was working at the time of the inspection, so. Okay, event was tested for carbon monoxide and none was detected. Period. You don't need to say time of inspection, time of inspection. Okay. Where's this water heater at? In the basement? Oh, there wasn't a basement. So this must be somewhere. Where is this thing located at? Is this in a garage? No, I hope not. Anyways, well, yep. Okay, good comment. Oh, water meter crawl space. I thought the water meter was under the kitchen sink. Am I correct or am I wrong? Where's that kitchen sink at? That looks like the water meter right there. All right. Am I right or am I wrong? Am I weak or am I strong? Sound off. 1, 2. Okay. Pretty sure that's what we got going here. I didn't see anything in the crawl space. it's all black pipe there. Yeah. Okay, let's move along. As or if needed, you might say it's okay. Okay, this is a standalone unit, Scott, so there's comment. So let's cut that. We're going to move that to the first spot here, paste. Okay, now we got this masthead. I imagine it's in good shape, so. Okay. Those are square D breakers. Oh, as you can see the square D right here. Yep, square D breakers. Yep. Yep. Yeah, these are all square D breakers. This is a new square D breaker. They got the logo on it. These are older square D breakers. So these are square D. They're just older. So anyways, let me whack that out of there. Okay, the open knockouts. Oh, let me. How many is there? I can't tell if that's an open knockout or not. Let me pull up the picture here. Okay, that's a double pull, but 1, 2. Okay, 2. Okay, so we should have a comment here, right here. Nope, where's it at? Oh, that's where I put this. That's where you... here is the knockouts. Open knockouts. There are two open knockouts in the main panel cover. Recommended inserted. Yep, so right there, boom. That's where you find those comments. So they don't go here. So let's see. Get rid of that picture there. Maybe we'll grab that and bring it back down. Pop it in here. There we go. Flip, small size. Oh, okay. Clearance or workspace. They could call that a workspace. Right. That's got an open knockout too. So let's go over here. Not sure if you addressed that or not. We can address it right here. So let's pop that picture down here. Where was that located at? In master bedroom closet. Okay. Good. And then R, right. Very good. So where are we at here? Okay. Let me just look at these. Did you open it up? I think you did on this one. I just can't find it. Here it is. Grounds and neutrals are isolated. That's not, I'm not too crazy about that, but boy, they got so much going on here at this house. Okay, so. This too. Okay. So well, a little bit. Let's see if we can find it here. Right here. put the main panel first. Okay, good. This is it. Yeah, it might be drawing too much power, you know. Let's see, it goes from this wire to the second breaker. I wonder what it's drawing on. Let's see. Main breaker, so that's drawing all the power in. It's probably not big enough. That can't be the main breaker because it's coming off of here. That's not a main breaker. That's labeled wrong. I'm not sure what they're running off of that one. But good comment. We'll put investigate instead of repair to further evaluate. Okay, well, this one's not being used, so. Nope, not being used. It should be replaced when needed. Right, so not a big deal right now. It's not being used. Oh, I'm not too worried about that. That don't look too bad, Scott. That's splitting hairs there, buddy. I'm more concerned about this other thing up here. Let me see. Right here, this breaker here has got, that's a two pole breaker, 60 amp with a small wire on it. This is, I wonder if this is the one that's feeding that sub panel box. You know what? Maybe it is. This wire here. Can't really see it. Let me see if I got another picture in here. I wonder if that wire is the one coming in here. See it here? No, I'm sorry. The main's coming here. This is the main coming in. So that's coming from over here. Yeah, right here. So that's the 40 amp breaker going in there. That's going out. So I'm not sure where this one's going. But anyways, we got to mention this one. So this one, I'm not too worried about this one. That's neither here nor there. That's neither here nor there. That's not bad. When they're way out, I mean, when you see them like an inch and a half out, you know, then you got to call it out. But these are very minimal. You're splitting hairs there. So I've never called that out. Let me just delete that. Create a new one. Let's find that. The breaker that I'm looking for here. I think it's this one right here. Yep, right here. A two-pole breaker, 60 amp, with this little bitty wire on it, and it's only a single circuit wire. A two-pole breaker is supposed to have 240, such as a dryer, an AC unit, electric heater, a water heater, you know, but this is a single current, so that's not good. So we got to go back over here. Let's drop it down in here. Okay. Okay, there was a two-pole 60 amp break in the main panel that had a single wire that was a single undersized wire, connected to it. Okay. Recommend an electrician to correct. The wire could be moved to another single breaker in the box. Recommend electrician to correct. Yeah. All right. So they possibly can move that wire down, but it depends on what size it is. You've got. Let me see if we can see. That looks like a 12 gauge wire, and that's probably a 20 amp breaker. Let me see if we can see what it is. Boy, I can't tell if that's a 20 amp breaker or not. I'm thinking it is, but I don't want to say it is. It could be a 30. It's hard to tell. That's a 20. I can see it. No, it's a 20. Good. So the wire could be moved to another single, to the single, to the wire could be moved to another single pole breaker in a box. There was a 20 amp breaker located directly below. Okay, we'll just leave it at that. Okay. Yep, good. We'll put an R on that one. Good. Good. You don't need to say varied. This is common of this for this age of home. Photos in there. It's hard to find anything. Where's that ceiling fan at? I don't see it, man. Okay. Updating, not upgrading. Updating kitchen knowledge, US air technology. Yep, good. And then I always like to use this comment here. Smoke detectors should be installed on each floor in each bedroom. Always make sure you put that. Good. Let's put an R here. That's an older furnace, so I don't want to. Okay, so we need that preset comment. There was a preset comment here, right here. Okay. Use this one. That should always pop in there, kind of like this electrical one here. It's always there, but you got to make sure it's separate. You got to separate it from the photos. Same here. This is always there. Separate it from the furnace. Okay. It's an older dated furnace, so we want to make sure they get it cleaned, serviced, and further evaluated. Cleaned, serviced, and further evaluated. evaluate. Okay, then we also want to use the comment. Let me see if I got it here. The wood stove comment. Where is it at? Right here. Right. So we want to put that in there. And we're going to put an R on there because that food pipe is pretty rusty. Okay. Now, wood stoves usually go down here, right here. See that? So let's move that down there because that's where it goes. So let me grab the comment. Cut. Paste. And then we'll get these photos here. Cut. That comment. Back this up one right there. Hit save. Okay, yep. We'll put an R on it. We'll get back to furnace, yep. Did you check it for CO? You should always check it for CO. Serviceman switch was present. I see the safety door switch, but didn't see it. the need of additional ducts. Heat ducts to all rooms. Okay. Yep. Gonna investigate there. Boy, I don't think there's, I don't know, man. I don't know if that's a high efficiency furnace or not. I don't think it is, but it could be, you know. So, because you don't, I don't have an overall picture of that furnace. Let me see something. Let me see what I can do here. Maybe they show a picture of it online. So they don't show the, they don't show it. All right, so anyways, I just thought maybe they would, sometimes they show pictures of the basement. All right, so there is no basement. Oh, let me go back to this heating. I'm just gonna delete this because I don't know. I'm not sure what's going on. Maybe the front, maybe the chimney is not being used. Now, if the chimney is not being used, you know what? Let me pause this for a second. I'm gonna try to text you. Okay. You had another. I just forgot to turn you on. But anyways, there was a second comment here. That had was talking about this flue pipe here. Anyways, I deleted it from this and just kept it over here because you already addressed it here. So we'll just leave it here. So we just got, I just texted you. I wanted to find out about this chimney and flue pipe here. So the ductwork. Now this is I thought I seen some pipes in the crawl space that looked like they were not attached. Is this it? It looks like it dips. This looks like it's hanging down. But perhaps it's going to a lower level, maybe to a laundry room or something. Maybe that's just the way it is. I don't know. I think this floor structure has got some spotting going on. Probably maybe a little bit of shrinkage. It looked like there was insulation installed and, you know, so you got to really look at that floor structure there. So let me go back over here to floor structure. Yeah, even this one here, this you can see the staining here. Yeah, so I'm gonna reword this. you'll be receiving an, I mean, okay, there was no, it's okay, being damned. Yeah, comma, I don't blame you. Okay, I'm over here texting, ignoring you. Okay, the floor's on a fair amount of standing from the crossways being damp. There it was. Is that like a mold-like substance? What would you call that? Like a mold-like substance or something? Or? Where's that at? Right here. Boy, that almost looks like a mold substance, a mold-like substance. Oh, again, I'm ignoring you. Okay, I'm over here texting. Okay, there was fungi substance on some of the floor, which I recommend cleaning and removing. Yep. Yeah, you can see that there. I don't know if you got any more pictures of the floor. They don't look too bad, but there are some areas that you got to look for shrinkage too, Scott. When you got a damp crawl space, okay, you got to look for shrinkage, like the bottom of these boards. They kind of like they cup up, and there's like a shrinkage. They shrink, like at the bottom. They shrivel up almost. If you look close at it, you'll see it. So really pay attention to that when you got a damp crawl space. Actually, it doesn't look too bad, but I see more stuff here. But I think that was what we were looking at that other picture. So, okay. Anyways. Okay. Good. All right. So where were we? We were somewhere. All right. Okay, good comment there. Okay, 3.2. Oh, I wanted 3.1. 3.1. Capital T. Good. Seems has got an A. Seems. That's vinyl flooring. You don't need to say at the time of the inspection it was loose. Yep. Well, it does. I mean, it's going to need to be replaced. Yep. This could be replaced. Somebody could lock themselves in. That's that's in a closet door. Your closet and garage is missing hardware. This should be replaced. Yeah, I don't want somebody, you know, somebody could lock themselves in. And then what? Man, oh man, they die, croak, or something. Where's that door at? It's a deadbolt. Oh, I see. There's a handle. There is a handle there. So, not a big deal. Yeah, you're almost taken away from this. Let me see if I can find that picture. Is it? Nope, that's not it. Too many pictures to choose from. Man, oh man. Yeah, that's all you need. Sometimes, you know, sometimes blowing it up like that is helpful, other times it's not. Are they failed thermal seals or? One. Okay. This is that same window right here. That's the upstairs window. So that's another one. Is that a casement window? Or is that just a sash? So. Let me put you on pause. Okay, I'm back with you. Okay. Let me just get rid of this first part here. I wonder if all the walls had foam board insulation or not. Let's see. It doesn't look like all the walls had insulation. So only some of the walls had. I want to mention this hanging insulation. Love friends and rich friends. Okay, I always separate the crawl space from the attic vents. I always separate the crawl space from the attic vents. I seen a ridge vent too somewhere. Well, he had a nice picture somewhere. Where was that bad boy at? Right here. Now, I don't want to say satisfactory because it's old and it's got this seal problem. Almost done here. No kidding. Yeah, you don't want to pretty it up. You said it in satisfactory condition with typical cracks. Now we're going to call this, you know, garage frontage has some settling cracks, but was in usable condition, right? We already addressed that. So we exclude it. That was a lot of work there, but pretty good job overall, man. I was pretty impressed. You did really good, nice and thorough. You know, we had a few corrections on the electrical and whatnot, but you'll learn that stuff. That's good stuff, man. You did really good. I'm pretty impressed. Let's see, we got the address is what I need. 3170. Let's see, man, he got a 275, but that should have been twice as much. That house would have died, man. So we need this one here. So, okay, so apparently there was none. So let me see if we got this hooked up. So first let's go, we're gonna go here. Not everything's been answered. So find next. Good, we can delete that because there's no AC unit. So find next, good. Okay, that's the sound I'd like to hear. All right, and then let me make sure I got you in here. I do. Okay, let me upload it. Then we'll come back and deal with that pest inspection later. Not crazy about that picture being cut off like that, but I think you got that offline, so it's actually not too bad of a picture. Let me see something here. Maybe we can find another picture. It just looks like it's cut off at the bottom. What size is that at? Probably go extra large on this one, being that it's cropped. So let me see how that looks. Yeah, there we go. Okay, I gotta downsize that picture. You haven't answered me yet. Okay, you're not answering me. You must be out and about. It's a Saturday night. Everything's all right. So let me, oh, it's the chimney. I think this chimney is possibly unused. I think that chimney is being unused. Not sure. Thinking it is. And then you said here the PVC proof I furnace were, and I don't know. I'm just gonna erase that. Okay. And then we're good to go. Okay. Let me go ahead and do your miscellaneous. Pest form. Oh God, I gotta, well, I can't do it right now. I gotta do it from, let me see. I have to get you set up to where you can do that. I think that was the date, wasn't it? Yep. Okay, good job, man. I'm gonna let you go. That was excellent. You did a great job. They all get easier from here on out, man. That house was a nightmare on Elm Street. Anyways, I was pretty impressed. You did a great job.